アロハ everyone and thank you so much for tuning into AlohaTV.com。 こんにちは、瀬川圭です。さて2013年、だいぶちょっと、月日が経ってしまいましたけれども、今年初のアロハ TV ということでお送りさせていただきます。改めて明けましておめでとうございます。 Happy New Year to everyone! How about your New Year's Day? さてたくさんの方がですね、やはりお正月を利用してこのハワイに、お越しになってました。もう年末年始本当にたくさんの方たちがいらしてですね、もうワイキの混み具合が私もですね手に取るように、分かっていたんですけれども、今はですねやはり1月の、今日は18日ということで、だいぶ、ワイキの方も、観光客の方は落ち着いてきた状態です。さてさて、年中ですね様々なイベントが行われているハワイなんですけれども、やはりハワイといえば、まあ、ビーチ、ショッピング、などがね思い浮かぶ方が多いと思うんですが、実はですねもう一つハワイで自慢できるものがアートなんです。一番有名なのがですね、このカピオラニ公園のところで、アートウォークという、ギャラリーがですね、毎月1回行われているんですけれども、そちらの方もですね日本人の間ではかなり今人気になっているんですが、実はですねそんなローカルの、アーティストの中でもですね今ダントツの人気を誇っているあの方の、今日はですね個展が開かれるということで、今日はこちらのカラカワ通りにありますグリーンルームにやってまいりました。そうです、サーファー、そしてハワイのアートといえば有名なのはヘザーブラウンさんですよね。なんとですねそのヘザーブラウンさんのもう正真正銘のインディビジュアルな個展が今日はこのグリーンルームで開かれます。もちろんあのヘザー本人が来てですね様々な、自分の作品に関しての、説明もしてくれるということで、今日はですね特別なインタビューもありますのでね、ぜひぜひ期待しておいてください。それでは早速中覗いてみます。行ってきます。あ、こんにちは、よろしくお願いします。よろしくお願いします。さあということで、こちらグリーンルームの室内にやってきました。もうねすでにたくさんの方がいらっしゃってるんですけれども、このギャラリーをですね、ぜひご案内をしていただきたい方がこちらにいらっしゃいますので、お話を伺ってみましょう。このグリーンルームのオーナーのじゅんさんです。よろしくお願いします。
よろしくお願いします。
はい、もうねあのワイキで知らない人はいないというぐらいもうじゅんさん有名なんですけれども、もういわゆるヘザーブラウンの生みの親と言っても過言じゃないですね。
いやもうそんなことはないですけど
、でもそもそもこのヘザーブラウンさんとあの出会ったきっかけって教えていただけますか。
そうです、まあ、6年前ぐらいになるんだけど、あのちょっとチャイナタウンに行った時に彼女と知り合って、でそこであの彼女の絵を見てもすごくあのこれだなと思って、でワイキキであの初めてっていうような形で、そしたらもう一気に人気が出て。
ジュンさん出会った頃はまだまだヘザーはあの無名ではあったんですか。
そうですね、あんま知ってる人はそのまだいない時
で。でもハワイっていろんなローカルのアーティストいるんですけど、なんでジュースさんこのヘザーブラウンさん の作品が目に留まったんですか。
もう本当にその絵のやっぱ力がもう他と全然違ったんで、もうこれだなと思って。
で実際に会ってどうぞ、まあ、口説き落とすって言ったら変ですけど時間かかりました。
いやもう会った時からもうすごくもうオープンな感じだったし、もう何の問題もなくもうじゃあいつ一緒にやろうっていう感じで。
そして今6年後もうこんな大盛況ですけども、じゅんさん自身このなんだろう盛り上がりって想像されました。
まあ、あんまそういうこと考えてなかったけども、もう予想以上にやっぱちゃんと形になってすごいなとつくづく思います。
やっぱりねそのじゅんさんのマーケティングも素晴らしかったと思うんですけども、ハワイはもちろんその日本でも大人気なんですってね。
そうですね、日本であの代官山で彼女のヘザーブラウンギャラリーっていうのをやってて、それは本当に彼女の作品だけを扱ってるギャラリーで世界に一つしかないの で、世界で多分一番種類も数もたくさんあるので、ぜひ日本の方も来てほしいです。
でもこのグリーンルーム、まあ、カラカワの本当中心地にありますけれども、やはりあのたくさん訪れるのは日本人の方が多いんですか。
そうですね、日本の方も多いですけど、ただオーストラリアとかあのメインランドの方ももちろん多いですし、本当やっぱどの世界の人が見てもやっぱすごくこう引きつけられるパワーのある絵だと思うので。
そして今日はこのヘザーブラウンのもうまさに個展、まあ、エクスキューシブの、ね、個展を開くということですけれども、グリーンルームさんの特徴、そのなぜ日本人の方に人気があるか かって分析したら、淳さん自身はどういうふうに思われます？
そうですね、こういうサーフアート、まあ、最近のこういうサーフアートを中心に扱ってるギャラリーってのはやっぱ他にもないし、
うん、
まあ、その理由は分かんないですけどね、
うん、でもやっぱり日本語が通じるって強いですね。
まあそうですね、
やっぱりいろんな、ね、お客さん質問があって、まあ、絵のこととか、まあ、例えば送料とかいろんなディテールを日本語で質問しても大丈夫？
大丈夫です、
うん。ではハワイではもうグリーンルーム、そして日本では代官山、ぜひぜひヘザーブラウン の中心絵を中心にですね取り扱っているギャラリーですので、ぜひ皆さん一度訪れてみてくださいね。オーナーの淳さんです。本当に淳さん、どうもありがとうございました。
ありがとうございます。
さあ、そして実はヘザー本人がいらしているということで、淳さんからちょっと呼び込んでいただきたいと思います。
ヘザ
ー、オーライ。なんとですね、ヘザー・ブラウンさん本人がこちらに来ているということですので、ちょっとですね、もう今すでにファンに囲まれているんですけども、ちょっとお呼びしたいと思います。Heather, are you available? Oh my goodness, good to see you!
You too! I'm happy to be here!
Yeah, thank you so much! 皆さん、本物です。 She's a real Heather Brown! Well, welcome, welcome! Thank you so much!
Thank you for having me!
Well, what do you think? I mean, you know, people are in the line and everybody's waiting for your, you know, art to see you. What do you think?
I am so beyond happy. You don't even know. I was printing up until this morning.
Oh.
And I had like had a half hour to get in the shower and come down. I was just like air drying the prints, trying to get them to dry fast. And I worked so hard on this and I had so much fun making all the art for it. And so now I'm so excited for everyone to see it.
Oh my goodness, and the cake.Wow. 今朝までギリギリまで、ね、アートワークに取り込んできて、もう急いでシャワーを浴びてこちらに来たという状況なんですけども。 So Heather, I know like your art is expanding to all the world. I mean, did you really imagine that was going to happen?
I never imagined it. Like I still, like, it surprises me and every day I'm amazed like, wow, mm-hmm. is this real? And it doesn't feel real. Like it's amazing.
Wow. In the Waikiki, I see your bus too.
Oh, right? I get so excited too when I see it every time. I love it.
Wow, そうなんです。もう今ね、ヘザーの商品もアートというのも、もういろんな世界中のところで目についてると思うんですけど、マイキではね、バスまで走ってますからね、もうかなり目立って本当に人々の注目を集めている、ものばかりなんですね。All right, Heather, probably everybody knows your profile, but just to review things, I know you study at the UH, right?
Yes, mm-hmm. I was a fine arts major in printmaking and also painting,
mm-hmm.
and I was also learning to surf at the same time. Uh-huh. I was a dive master, a boat captain, so constantly in the ocean and uh-huh. having so much fun in it, and so
uh-huh.
I would then just paint what I love, like everything around me. I'm in love with Hawaii and all the beauty it has, and so that's how I express it, that I enjoy Hawaii every day and just want to share it with everyone. Mm-hmm. It's a special, magical place.
Mm-hmm. So it was kind of your dream that you want to be like a professional artist?
Oh, it was a dream, but not a dream that I thought could ever come true. I just thought, wow, that would be the best, but I thought it's so difficult. And so mm-hmm. I feel so surprised, like I feel mm-hmm. so lucky every day that mm-hmm. I'm living my dream.
Mm-hmm.Yeah, and I just talked to June and heard like how like you guys met, like he saw your art in the Chinatown, and then he asked you, and then you guys became really close right away. Probably you had a lot of chances, but were you looking for the chance or like chance came to you?
I just feel like since I've been with June and working with the gallery that every year the business is getting better and better, and so I feel like we're really good friends and a really good team. Mm-hmm. So it's really good to every year do new things and have new shows mm-hmm. and just expand more art to the world mm-hmm. together.
Mm-hmm. But what was the biggest like change, like your life turning point to be like artist Heather Brown from a UH student?
Oh, that was when I was hired by Jack Johnson to create his poster art for his Kakua Fest.
Mm-hmm.
And I remember being there and seeing the whole stage was my art. And everyone mm-hmm. walking around had t-shirts with my art on it. And I was just seeing it everywhere. And then Jack Johnson's wearing it and singing. And I just uh-huh. felt like, wow, this is crazy. I can't believe this is real. And,
wow.
I've just got out of college and I just uh-huh. never thought that anything like that could happen for me.
That was just out of college?
Maybe a year or two after college. Yeah.
Wow.
And it just happened, Kim found me, his wife, just uh-huh. Selling art at the Hollywood Arts Fest, uh-huh, and I didn't uh-huh. even know it was her, and she was there with her kids, and uh-huh. we were talking, and she bought some of my art that day and brought it home, and
uh-huh.
called me about a week later and asked if I wanted to do the poster, and
wow.
I felt like, wow, a really good happening.
It's like a Cinderella story.
Yes.
Right? Wow. So did you have, like, you know, the taste of your art, like, you know, right now, if everybody sees your art, you know, we know right away it's Heather Brown. Did you have that taste, like, from the beginning?
Yes, in fact, I remember being in college and saying to my teacher, I want to make art that no one's made before, that's unique, where they see it and they know it's me. And he said, oh no, everything's been done already, you know, you can't do anything new. And so I made it my goal, you know, I'm going to make something like totally unique to me, and worked so hard at it, and finally it's happening, and it's just unreal.
Wow. Right now, you know, Heather Brown, everybody's waiting for you, you know, to get your autograph, but I have exclusive interview with her right now, sorry. But I heard that you went to, like, a lot of traveling last year. How was it?
Oh, it was great. Uh-huh. Oh, so much fun. Uh-huh. Definitely. I enjoy it.
And where did you go? You got inspired from some countries?
Oh, I've been to Japan, plenty. Mm-hmm. Australia, Bali, Tahiti, Fiji, a bunch of places. Mainland Colorado. I'm having new inspiration from Colorado. And it's just fun to show my art to new areas and meet new fans and friends and just share my art with the world.
So is it kind of inspire you, like, if you get out of Hawaii and then, you know, meet new people, see all the, you know, new towns, new countries, is it really inspire you?
It does, and it's funny what inspires me. Like, sometimes it will be a bird in that area or a certain tree, you know, there's so many little things. That's usually not a whole picture, and I think, like, oh, I might go back and do a Hawaii picture with this Australian tree in it. Just I'm inspired by nature, you know, and animals, and just the beauty of a sunset maybe, or the ocean. So sometimes I borrow it from other places I've been, but I always wanted to incorporate Hawaii into it, like keep it with that magical aloha feeling you get when you're here. I want to keep that in my painting.
So always base is Hawaii.
Yeah, it always has a little bit of flavor in there.
Oh, I see. Well, 今ね、昨年ヘザーさんが色んな国を旅をしたってお話だったんですけれども、やはり新しい方に出会ったり、新しいものを見たりすごくその自分のアートに影響があってインスピレーションされるらしいんですね。ただやはり、ベースはハワイ。その中にいろんな他の国のものを取り入れたりしていくというのが自分の、やり方らしいんですよね。 Alright, so Heather, like, whenever, like, you try to, you know, draw art, you know, think, do you have something that you cannot miss, like music or, I don't know, coffee or whatever?
Coffee really? Every morning, yeah. Okay. And having my dogs and my cats around me, they hang out in the studio with me, and I play music, and just kind of get into that happy feeling, like, things that make me happy and I enjoy, like, I drink tea all afternoon, take time, like, take little breaks, like, to go out in the yard in the sun and check out my chickens or see what chickens. I'm growing, like, have a garden. Or maybe, like, take a little break, go surf, you know, something to just kind of keep me refreshed, because I can't sit for too long and paint, you know, I gotta, like, take little breaks here and there, and so it's good to just kind of feel the sunshine, see a rainbow. It's just like a little extra inspiration every day.
So actually, like, can you just draw everywhere, or you need to do the preparation?
I really like to paint in my studio, just being in that environment. I work really well. It's kind of hard for me to paint in the hotel sometimes. You know, and I get a little messy, so I'm always paranoid. Like, I'm going to get paint on the floor or on the desk.
You don't want to pay for it.
We're at home, I get paint on my dogs even, you know, like, it gets everywhere. So I have a little restraint whenever I'm not in my studio. But, I do sketch. When I get ideas, I do little drawings. And sometimes those drawings end up coming at home, and I develop a painting from them, and it ends up being a great painting. So, it just kind of, like, gets in my memory, and I have that sketch to look back on.
Oh, I see. So today, you know, this is exclusive Heather Brown, right? But